Harry, general thoughts on the game?
Just thought we got behind deficit-wise a little bit too much than we're normally used to. Third quarter, I think we let the league get up to about 16 to 17. Us just simply not, executing our press the proper way. Fourth quarter, finally we stepped up defensively and the energy was finally there. And we made the run, got up 70 to 67. And then, they made the buck, ran one. And then down the stretch, they made the free throws. I just thought we didn't play well. I didn't think we played well. And that's a combination of us not playing well and North Point playing well.
Anything defensively they gave you guys problems with?
Not in particular. We had known from the scouting them that they were going to press a lot. They were going to double real quick and try to trap a lot. So that intensity level, we've seen it. And, it was like I said, it was a combination of us missing shots and a combination of their intensity on defense. Without a doubt, they played a great game, and we give them a lot of credit for winning.
How much momentum-wise, Ricky got three fouls in the first half. Momentum-wise, how did that, stymie your team a little bit? Because Ricky is your second scoring option.
All throughout the season, whether it's Ricky or Maurice or Correll or other guys stepping up, I don't think it really mattered too much. I just think we got outplayed tonight and outcoached tonight.
Did you think this game was yours to win once you finally overtook them? Because y'all were down most of the way, and it seemed like you had a huge momentum swing there.
You think that, but as the game went along, you watch so many games. Usually teams that get behind that much make that run, and then usually it goes back the other way. You're hoping 70 to 67. I think number 44, Muhammad, or either him or 12, got the N1. Sevens got the N1 and then made the free throw. And then, down the stretch, he was right from the line. I don't know what, 8 for 9 from the line. So, he definitely executed down the stretch.
Ricky, just kind of talking about that run that you guys made to get back into it. I mean, like you said, you were struggling as a team for a while, but you made that run. Just kind of talk about how you guys put that together.
Called the timeout. Cool shit, you got to pick it up on defense. And as a team, we just called out one of our presses, and that's how we turned our defense up.
Mr. Carr, I'm a reporter from down in Southern Maryland, and there's a lot of talk about you, and I know you've got more than your team is comprised of more than just you, but obviously with what you've done and all the footage that's out there, how would you evaluate how North Point played you, and did you sense from the get-go that they were ready to take it to you, and they were, you kind of had a bullseye on you, they wanted to prove to you that they could play?
Yeah, they're a good team. Like, they're a good defensive team. Like, they send a lot of defenders at you, try to confuse you up, try to double team you a lot. But just kept my head and played in the flow. Yeah, they're just a good team.
How would you evaluate the way you played?
I played my hardest, but I really didn't give them my all because I really couldn't do too much.
Is that a credit to the defense?
Yeah, credit to their defense.
Late in the game, Akil, talk about and I was kind of standing right behind you, that inbounds play that was intercepted. Kind of what happened there, and was a breakdown there, or just was a bad pass?
I guess was a misunderstanding. Me and my teammate, miscommunication, and I just thought he was coming back to the ball, but I just threw it because I thought I didn't want to get a 5-second call. I should have just called a timeout, but just was trying to get the ball.
Akil, you're so used to winning on every level that you play, and you guys had a great season. Obviously, a tough loss to North Point. Does this give you a little bit extra motivation to come back next year and try again for a state championship?
Yeah, I'm definitely going to bring my team back next year. We're just going to have to play extra harder, more defense, and try to get an over.
Akil, what do you think it was tonight? What was it about tonight as far as the slow start and just having to come back from such a long deficit?
It just our team, like, we used to, like, coming out. We're not really used to, like, coming out just stepping on the gas right there. Like, we was too laid back, and they just was taking it towards. So the second half, we had talked to each other. They know that's going to be our half. But they made some runs. We made some runs. We made a big run. And that's when they just came back. They executed down the line, made free throws.
Harry, how disappointing is this? A great, great season, but you guys have talked about the goal being winning a state championship and being that close and not getting it.
It's really not disappointing at all because, you know, I mean, 20 years from now, who's going to remember who won the state championship? What I told them is, you know, 20 years from now, I hope to know them, that none of them are in prison, that none of them are, you know, have been killed or anything. You know, so that's the bigger picture. We won our first championship since 76. We won a regional title. You can't take that away from us. So it is not disappointing at all. We battled. We just came up short to a better team today.
Coach, there's some of the adjustments you made in the second half. You knew, like, North Point threw a lot of bodies at you, but how were you able to, you know, put the team in
your package? I just was looking at the defenders, like, when they put number five on me, I know I could beat them on the dribble. Put number three on me, I just got working on my offense, just come around. They were double teaming me a lot, so I was just looking for the open man, hit the open shot.
What were your impressions of Marquise Wright? He's a sophomore, same grade as you're in.
He played good. Like, he working in that system, like, they got a lot of plays that's going through him. So it's basically like he a good player, good defensive player.
Is he a tough guard for you?
Yeah, he's a tough guard, but man, he just came out, made a couple plays, and just played good defense.
Akil, talk a little bit about just the thought running through your mind after the game. A lot of people look at the YouTube highlights, but they don't see the work that you put in. They don't see the camaraderie of you and your teammates. They may think that you're this cocky person, but people who kind of spend some time with you and get to know you know that you're confident, but you love the game, you love to work. Talk a little bit about the emotional toll after the game, the tears, and just the hurt and the pain, and what you were thinking about knowing what you guys put in and knowing how much of a family you guys have been this year.
I'm just happy for my seniors, Ricky and Corral and Marlis, that they played on my team. I got them this fall, tried to get them a state championship before they left. But I got us a city one and a region one. But they just work hard. We worked hard together every day in practice. So basically, like, after the game, it just was a lot going through my mind to get my team the state championship that I always wanted. But at least I got them a city championship for region. So we basically went 2-for-1, just lost a big one next year, just trying to come back and get another one. And hopefully they can just come and watch us.